this point we're going to bow our heads to pray. I'm going to call out highly revered King Theatre Suite to lead us in prayer. Very short prayer.
Let us pray. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Heavenly Father, we God, you be with us today. Guide and direct us. Be with us. Bless us. And see that whatever we do, praise and glory in the name. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. At this point, let me hand the microphone to the Deputy Managing Director of BDIC. And will probably welcome us and tell us why we're here. That this one is put our hands together for Tammy and Lazio.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency, Governor of Bayelsa State, Your Excellency, the Nigerian High Commissioner to the UK, our Majesties, our Royal Highnesses, Lord Mayland, ladies and gentlemen, welcome. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you here today as we witness another milestone in the implementation of Your Excellency, Governor of Bayelsa State's vision to diversify Bayelsa's economy as we prepare for life beyond oil and gas. Today, we are going to open up the BDIC UK headquarters and indeed our international headquarters today, as we did in May of last year when we decided to open our office in Johannesburg, South Africa. Our reason, which is very strategic, of opening the UK office is not just only predicated on the fact that the UK is the world international capital market, but also how we can leverage UK to reach out to the rest of Europe and exploit our relationships with the Commonwealth to bring needed resources back to Bayelsa. BDIC is very cardinal to the implementation of the diversification of the state's economy. So, in doing that, we are focused on specific sectors that I'm going to touch on today very briefly, and hopefully in the course of the cocktail, we'll have a chance to interact and explore opportunities for partnerships, in way of financial partnership as well as technical partnership. Our sectors are quite simply four or five major. We like to think of exploring areas where we have competitive and comparative advantages like agriculture and aquaculture, where we think of industrializing agriculture and aquaculture because of the vast species that we have, especially in the marine, you know, we're part of the Niger Delta. We're also interested in focusing on oil and gas, where we want to explore the entire value chain or hydrocarbon value chain, where we're looking at petrochemicals, upstream, midstream, as well as downstream. As you know, Bayelsa, luckily, has a wealth of over 30 to 40% of the nation's oil and gas reserves. And so it makes a lot of sense that naturally, since we have the feedstock, that we can also focus on the power sector. We want to make Bayelsa the power hub of the country, West Africa. We also want to extend with that type of infrastructure in roads, bridges, airports, seaports that will make the economy much more viable, and we're looking to UK for partnerships. We're also interested in the tourism and hospitality space. As you all know, Bayelsa has the longest shoreline, in Nigeria, with over 125 kilometers of white sandy beaches. So we're looking to explore that. We've also become number one in event tourism, where we host a lot of the events, national events in the country, in Bayelsa. We're also interested in manufacturing. the entire chain from small business growth to big industry, especially since we're expanding or building out a series of industrial parks that would help grow our manufacturing base. I could go on and on explaining about different sectors, but I'll have to cut it short at this point. Just to say, enjoy with us. Thank you for coming. As we discuss opportunities going forward. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I think we come to the moment. We'll have to cut this tape. At this point, I'd like to invite His Excellency, the Governor of Bayelsa State. He will be led by all the dignitaries here in front to officially cut this tape. The big tent is always open. And thereafter, you will take a guided tour to the offices. At this point in time, it's my pleasure to invite His Excellency to officially cut the tape to declare his office open. Your Excellency, so give a short video.
Thank you, TK. Don't want your whole chair with you. The High Commissioner of the Federal Republic of Nigeria to the Court of St. James, Dr. Senator Dalatu Tafida, who's here with us, let me particularly appreciate the presence, support and solidarity of the Right Honorable Lord Merland, Chair of the Commonwealth Business Council, who's here, and also our very good friend, the Right Honorable Robertson, who also chairs the Westminster African Business Group. Your Royal Majesty, King Gedespif, a minor of Tom Brass, first military governor of Old River State. Your Excellencies, members of the State Executive Council, the Deputy Managing Director of BDIC, very capable and supportive and hardworking Corporation Secretary who put this event together. Captains of industry, friends of Bayelsa State, friends of Nigeria, members of the High Commission staff who are here, ministers and councillors of the High Commission of Nigeria who are here, very distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Today it gives me great honor and privilege at this time to, with your support, formally declare the international headquarters of the Bayelsa Development and Investment Corporation open. This is our international headquarters. And we have done this in a very humble view that it will promote and coordinate international investments in Bayelsa, and so doing, deepen and strengthen our collective resolve to create wealth and spread prosperity, and also promote the excellent bilateral relations that our country has with this great country, the excellent relationships we have within the Commonwealth. It is therefore my singular honor and privilege, with your support, today to formally declare this office open. Your support. May I request that Lord Mallow, at least you have a hand to the tape. And same for, yes, Right Honorable Robertson. And from the Royal Father back home, let me do so in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and to the service of humanity, to the glory of God Almighty. Amen.
as we move along in this journey, just know that we'll continue to count on you. First, I would like to make a simple presentation to three very special guests who are here. That does not mean others are not special. All of you are very special guests. But it's my honor and privilege to just present a special Bayelsa souvenir. First to the Nigerian ambassador to the court of St. James, who, as you all know, is a household name in Nigeria. But beyond that, for the past couple of years, he's been in London promoting the excellent bilateral relations between the Federal Republic of Nigeria and the United Kingdom. And in that capacity, we all know that he has also been promoting investments, deepening trade relations, and generally serving our people so very well. I'd like to therefore, on behalf of the government and the good people of Bayelsa State, the glory of all lands, present a simple black sun. It's a handkerchief. But it's a very special handkerchief. And you can't get this from any other place. It bears the sacred colors and crests of our state. It's my singular honor and privilege, sir, to present this to you as a token of our appreciation. Several years, or let's say decades, of meritorious and selfless service to humanity. Congratulations, sir. Thank you. I would also like, in the same vein, to present, this is bluish, maybe because the gentleman we are talking about is dressed in blue as well. I also love blue. That makes us. 3 weeks ago, about 3 weeks ago, I was here. I led a small team. I was here in the UK, and I had the honor and privilege of meeting some of the best gentlemen you can ever find anywhere. One of them, the gentleman who is here, is a lord. He's of the very, very up. You know, it's not like and that is the chairman of the Commonwealth Business Council, the Right Honorable Lord Mallam, who is here with us and who was very gracious on that day. And we held a lot of very exciting discussions. And he was gracious also to take us around the hallowed chambers of the House of Lords. And took us around, and I learned a lot of British history that day. I want to thank you for your very gracious hospitality. And for today, I'd like to express particularly the profound gratitude and appreciation of the government and the good people of Bayelsa State that you were able to come here in spite of your time schedule to join us in opening this an investment office, and we hope that moving forward we'll continue to count on you as we in the Commonwealth work together to create wealth and promote prosperity. Congratulations that I present this to you on behalf of the government of Bayelsa. Possible. The man who is doing a great job, leading a great body, And I'd like to again convey my personal gratitude to you, sir, and to your group. Let me also, on behalf of the government and the good people of my state, appreciate your warmth and your friendship and your readiness to support our dreams and our visions of creating wealth and spreading prosperity back home in the great state of Bayelsa. Thank you for your gracious invitation. And thank you especially that today you were able to come to join us as we begin to walk the talk. Because I meant everywhere that I spoke that day. I was serious when I said we should do more within the Commonwealth to create wealth and expand the frontiers of our economy. I was serious when I said that in Africa, we should do the same. I was serious when I said that in vain do we build political relations and diplomatic ties without translating them to concrete economic prosperity. And that was why we started the African head office in Johannesburg, I think a year ago. And this is the international head office, which coordinates all our international investment endeavors. And so, Sir Robertson, I'd like to thank you very much for your friendship and solidarity. And on behalf of the government and the good people of Bayelsa State, it's my singular honor and privilege to present this to you and members of your group as a token of appreciation. Thank you very much.
Feel proud to be part of it.